Hi, my name is Gerhard Schwander and welcome to Selling Power TV. Today we have the pleasure of meeting with Christopher Lee. He's Vice President, Solution Engineering with Obero.
Hi,
did I pronounce this correctly?
You did. Yeah. Well, it's Obero, but
Obero. Explain the name, Obero.
Obero actually came from the Shakespeare play, Midsummer Night's Dream. So it's a play on Oberon, actually, the king of the, I believe it's the king of the forest.
Right.
Yeah, the founder came up with that, so.
Tell me about the company.
So we're a software company based out of Toronto, Canada. We've got a location in Romania as well as one in the US. And our focus is on sales performance management. So we've got a slightly unique play on our offering versus the other incumbent vendors in the space. So most of the vendors in the space within sales performance management focus on either sales planning or sales execution, but really don't kind of bridge the gap between the two. So our focus is really trying to bridge that gap. Right, so that means that we provide solutions for sales planning and forecasting, incentive compensation management, sales profitability management, and one of our more recent offerings is sales predictive analytics. Right, so we're really trying to kind of integrate the processes that support sales, sales ops, HR, and finance. Right, so somewhat of a unique offering.
So who is using the software primarily?
I'd say the primary user is probably the sales operations team.
Right.
The low-hanging fruit is always incentive compensation management, right? That's
right.
Usually our foot in the door.
Right.
And with that, it's, you know, compensation team. Sometimes the sales operations teams oversee it. Sometimes even finance is sometimes involved, especially when it comes time to actually push the results of your commission calculations
right.
to the payroll. Finance usually has some sort of overlay there, but I would say mainly it's sales operations that we work with.
So what is the trend that you see in more analytics moving into the sales operations space?
So we're finding that traditionally this has been a relatively slow moving space in the sense that, you know, for about 15 years or so, there's been companies that have been helping automate incentive compensation management. The way we look at things is that's one piece of the pie. You can't just start and stop with incentive compensation management. You need a broader capability. And the other capabilities were typically and traditionally managed within Excel. So really what we're trying to do is provide a solution which replaces Excel, right? So if you were to think of the way our solution works, it's really almost like Excel on steroids is actually how sometimes we, you know, position it to our
right.
customers, where we leverage all of the great things of Excel, you know, kind of the free form nature, the fact that everyone is familiar with it, right? The kind of the formatting capabilities mm-hmm. that are available to Excel, but we strip away all the bad things. Lack of data integrity. You know, traditionally Excel heavy processes require people to manage these Excel workbooks, distribute them amongst a number of people, and sometimes there's data integrity issues, right? Because you kind of get lost in the mix of these Excel workbooks. So what we do is we leverage the Excel look and feel, but we connect an underlying central database to Excel and then publish that to the web. So all of the bad things with Excel get stripped away.
Do you have any numbers, any research that sort of show that
one of the major things that they
this will accelerate
is,
deals
say,
because
insight.
Of that tool?
We find that, you know, traditionally anyways, what it does do is it eliminates them spending time on things that don't help close deals, right?
Right.
So there's this concept of shadow accounting,
right.
which is really just a fancy term for saying that sales reps have not a lot of trust in what it is they're being told that they earn. Right, so what they do is they spend a lot of time on the back of a napkin trying to kind of reconcile, I closed
right.
this deal and that was for $1,000, so I'm supposed to get 5% of that,
right.
you know, et cetera, et cetera. And all of that time is, of course, unproductive time. It's
right.
non-selling
right.
time, right? So the more time they spend doing that, the less time they sell, spend selling.
Yeah, and I imagine you make it easier for the sales manager to avoid commission disputes because everything is
yep.
recorded and visible to both.
That's right. So normally what we find is even with some of the automated solutions out there is the system still calculates the compensation and then disseminates the comp statement at the
right.
end of the period.
Right.
That might be a quarter. That's just
right.
not fast enough.
Right.
right. So what we provide is real-time insight. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So as soon as a deal is closed, it integrates with whatever system is used to
right.
capture that deal, flows into our system. We calculate the incremental
mm-hmm.
compensation based on that deal and then distribute it both to the sales manager, to the sales rep. So gone are the days where, you know, everything is inundated at the end of the pay period where, you know, all of the reps review their statements and say, hey, you
right.
know what, there's a problem with this, that, and that. Now, as those issues come up, because they don't get eliminated altogether,
right?
right? But as those issues come up, then they can be dealt with at that time.
Right.
So you kind of spread the, you know, the management of the process over a period of time
right.
rather than all at the end of the period, right?
Christopher, how can people learn more about Obero.com?
There's a number of different ways. We actually have two websites. One is oberospm.com, right? And we have a very deep-seated solutions team, and that website is oberosolutions.com, right? We also are, we come to a lot of the trade shows, a lot of the conferences, like Sales 2.0 as an example, right? So we're really getting the name out there, and there's a lot of different avenues to come visit and learn more about the organization.
So if you want to enjoy a Shakespearean play, go to your website.
That's right, oberospm.com.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, Gerard. I appreciate it.